All right, ladies and gentlemen, how we doing this morning? I go by the name of DJ Shake, and I'm here to give you those international vibes. Welcome to Global Cleveland's annual meeting 2021, presented by Medical Mutual. I hope you all here to have a great time. We're going to go ahead and get this party started off right. So sit back, enjoy your coffee, and enjoy the vibes.
Como si fuera la última vez, y enséñame ese pasito que no sé, un besito bien suavecito, bebé, taqui, 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 taqui. Prende los motores de Kawasaki. En la discoteca Jenny llegaron los Anunnaki. No le baje, el booty sobresale de tu traje. No trajo pa' que el nene no trabaje. Es que yo me sé lo que ella cree que ya se sabe. Cuenta que no quiere, pero me tiene espionaje. El booty sobresale de tu traje. No trajo pa' que el nene no trabaje. Es que yo me sé lo que ella cree que ya se sabe. Cuenta que no quiere, pero me tiene espionaje. Báilame como si fuera la última vez, y enséñame ese pasito que no sé, un besito bien suavecito, bebé. Taqui, taqui, taqui.
Me gusta mi reggae.
Cuando yo la vi, dije si esa mujer fuera para mí. Perdóname, te lo tenía que decir. Tatura.
Everything, everything, you know it. King already, already, you know it. Shine already, it's time already. The line already, it's time already. Shine already, it's time already. The line already, it's time already.
Try to stop it, you say no, no, no. Royalty say but you no, no, no. Try to stop it, you say go, 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 go. Bubble up and watch it go, go, go.
King be ruler, be ruler, yeah. Everybody on the conquer, yeah. Every king be stronger, yeah. King the rule them long day. Remember who you are, oh. Real king always be new. Give up your bread, oh. And show your people my love.
Sang my ready, I say you sang my ready. You like my ready, I say you like my ready.
Calling you got the remedy, I say you got the remedy.
Shine your body, shine your body.
Long live the king, you king, you know it. King already, already, you know it. Top everything, everything, you know it.
I need you in the morning, but I need you now. up in mine. And I mean, they make you free up your mind. Say your body talk to me nice. Say now my love you didn't need for your life. Yeah, I love to be like. Say every day together, yeah, day and night. Yeah, if I leave, you go bye. Yeah, if you leave, I go
stroking your back, baby. Loving your body, baby. As you're whining your body, baby. So crazy. Loving your body, baby. Girl, you want me to me.
Send it right on over to Norm Steiner to get you guys going. All right, once again, I go by the name of DJ Shake. It's been my pleasure rocking with you. See you soon. All right, Norm, take it away.
Welcome to Global Cleveland's virtual annual meeting. We're so happy that you could join us this morning as we celebrate Global Cleveland's 10th anniversary. My name is Norm Steiner, and I'm a longstanding member of the Global Cleveland Board and also the Vice President of Major Accounts for Medical Mutual. I'm excited to be here today to kick off Global Cleveland's annual meeting, where you'll not only hear about the incredible work the team has accomplished over the past year, but also help us honor some of the amazing community leaders who are changing our region for the better by welcoming and supporting international newcomers. Global Cleveland was established 10 years ago by a group of passionate people and organizations that understood the value of attracting, welcoming, and connecting international newcomers to Cleveland and Cuyahoga County. From workforce connections to social and educational opportunities, Global Cleveland has worked to transform our city into an international hub of innovation, shared prosperity, and economic growth. This virtual work cannot be done alone. Global Cleveland has spent the past decade building equitable relationships and partnerships across the state, the region, the nation, and the world to expand access to newcomers and to help them achieve economic success. They collaborate with nonprofits, city builders, foundations, residents, and companies, and all of you to support and integrate newcomers. As the presenting sponsor, Medical Mutual is proud to support Global Cleveland and the work the team does every day to be the most welcoming city in America. Thank you again for joining us today. Please enjoy this brief look at Global Cleveland over the past year.
there has been an increase in Asian American violence. And this is something that not only needs to be recognized, it really needs to be understood and acknowledged.
So we want to show you how to take advantage of the immense global talent in our region, whether they are attending colleges, whether they're resettling, or if they have just chosen, like me, Cleveland as their home.
Now, thank you to Global Cleveland and all the partners for putting together this important conversation about how we can make Cleveland a more welcoming city for all of our immigrants moving to the city of Cleveland.
Do people dance? We love to eat their food. Do we love them?
We have so much in common. We have a common interest. All of us, not just communities of color, but all of us have a common interest in unifying our world.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us here as we celebrate Global Cleveland's 10th anniversary and honor the community members who are all making a difference here in Cleveland. My name is Joe Simperman, and I'm proud to work with and for this amazing organization. I want to take this moment to thank our board member, Norm Steiner, for helping us kick off our meeting, and of course, Medical Mutual for being our presenting sponsor once again this year. As you watched our annual video, this past year has been full of meaningful connections and achievements, in spite of the challenges that we have all faced as one community. Despite these challenges, we are currently joined on this annual meeting with people in 12 time zones and 24 different countries. I'm especially proud of the work our staff and board have done to ensure that our international community is fully informed and is supported in its access to the COVID-19 vaccine, to language access, and to all the rights and privileges that our sisters and brothers from around the world deserve as members of our Greater Cleveland family. I want to thank my work family, Nancy Janis, Allison Redder, Elizabeth Kuzma, Colin Derrick, Rosarita DeMillo, Gwendolyn Kocher, Supriya Tamang, Fatima Rahman, Melissa Berte Bila, and William Worling for all the great work that they do every single day here at Global Cleveland on behalf of our international community. What we have all accomplished, all of us, our viewers, our board, our staff, our sponsors, our donors, and our founders is remarkable in the last 10 years and would not have been possible without the thousands of people from our volunteers, our board, our supporters, and our participants in all the collaboration that we do each day to ensure our international community and our international newcomers, our immigrants, our refugees, our secondary migrants, our international students are not only welcomed, but truly made to be a part of our community. We have also been fortunate to do this important work with the full support of our state, county, and local governments. We are very grateful to Governor Mike DeWine, whose leadership during the pandemic ensured that the international community was not left out of the vaccination efforts or our economic recovery. And Global Cleveland has been honored to work with Mayor Jackson for the past 10 years. And we want to express our sincerest gratitude to him and to Chief Valerie McCall for the leadership and collaborative spirit that we have seen from the city of Cleveland. We are also excited to share this same close, collaborative, and growing relationship with Mayor-elect Bibb, as we did with Mayor Jackson and his administration. My friends, here with a special message to our Global Cleveland family, including each and every one of you, are our Governor Michael DeWine, the Honorable Mayor Frank Jackson, and the Honorable Mayor-elect Bibb.
Hello, I'm Ohio Governor Mike DeWine. Global Cleveland, congratulations on your 10th anniversary. Your work to attract, welcome, and connect international newcomers builds upon the rich cultural heritage of Cleveland. Both Cleveland and Ohio are more vibrant because of your ongoing efforts. I also want to thank you for partnering with our administration this past spring to ensure that the immigrant community in Cleveland was included in our COVID-19 vaccination efforts. Global Cleveland answered our call. By the end of the mass vaccination site at the Wolstein Center, Global Cleveland had made more than 4,500 vaccination appointments for immigrant workers and their families. I'm proud to acknowledge your tremendous work. Once again, congratulations on 10 years. I can't wait to see what you accomplish in the next 10.
Hi, how are you doing? I want to thank Global Cleveland, President Joe Semperman, and the entire Global Cleveland team for recognizing me. But I really want to thank them for two things. One, for the work that they do. And the work that they do in terms of not only immigration, but of refugees. And thank them also for looking out for the least of us. Because whenever we are involved in a global crisis and there are people who are suffering and there are people who need a safe haven to come to, Global Cleveland has been there. And they've advocated for people, again, not just those who can take the traditional route of immigration, but for those who've been displaced based on war or social condition or famine or those kinds of things that have caused people to suffer. Global Cleveland has been a tremendous advocate for them to bring them to Cleveland. So again, I want to thank Global Cleveland for the recognition, particularly Joe Semperman, and I want to thank them for the great work that they've done.
Hi, this is Mayor-elect Justin Bibb. Over the past decade, Global Cleveland has opened up our city to the world, welcoming thousands of immigrants who choose to call Cleveland home. On the 10th anniversary, we celebrate the work and honor the leaders who helped create economic opportunity for all. Congratulations to all the 2021 award winners. What makes a place feel like home is connection. connection to jobs, community, and culture. I look forward to working in partnership with Global Cleveland to connect immigrants and refugees to our community and enrich the diversity of our city.
Thank you so very much to Governor DeWine, to Mayor Jackson, and to Mayor-elect Bibb. We have been honored to work with and for you. We are looking forward to continuing working with you, and we appreciate your leadership, innovation, imagination, collaboration, dedication, and passion for our international newcomer community. And now for our board report. It gives me a great honor to introduce Mr. David Fleshler, our long-serving board chair, who will provide this report. David is responsible for the Office of Global Strategy at Case Western Reserve University. He has been working for a decade to identify and pursue local, state, national, and international connections for Northeast Ohio and Case Western. And he provides those connections to each and every one of us every day. He is a guiding force and a warm light for Global Cleveland, committed to helping newcomers and our community succeed. Mr. David Fleshler.
Thank you, Joe. I am so pleased to be here this morning with all of you as we mark the 10th anniversary of Global Cleveland. I have been a member of the board since its inception and have been fortunate to serve as board chair since our first chair, Baiju Shaw, stepped down as chair, although he remains on the board. Congratulations, Baiju, on your appointment as president and chief executive officer of the Greater Cleveland Partnership. You understand the importance of migrants, immigrants, and refugees to the economic success of our region, and we look forward to working closely with you in the years ahead. I have witnessed firsthand how Global Cleveland has evolved over the past 10 years, and how many lives have been impacted by the work that this small but mighty team achieves every day. I'm also lucky to be able to witness the leadership of Joe Simperman, who is the driving force behind the success of our organization. I want to also acknowledge the remarkable dedication and work of all the members of our professional staff, Elizabeth Kuzma, Colin Daring, Rosarita DeMillo, Gwendolyn Kocher, Nancy Janice, Fatima Rahman, Allison Redder, and Supriya Taman. They are all the doers in our organization, the people who work so hard every day to carry out the mission of Global Cleveland. Thank you for your great efforts, your passion, and your dedication. It is safe to say that Global Cleveland is close to my heart, and I am proud to chair an engaged board of directors that represent the breadth of our community. I am also pleased to share that we have added three new members of our board since the beginning of the year. They are Elise James DeCruz, Chief Diversity Officer at the Ad Council, Margarita S. Karencevich of Council at Benish, Friedlander, Copeland, and Arnoff, and Matt Carroll, Chief Economic Growth and Opportunity Officer for Cuyahoga County. Elise, Margarita, and Matt join the board of an organization dedicated to embracing the economic success and prosperity of all international newcomers. Our mission includes advocating for inclusion and social justice, making language access widely available, creating programming to expand workforce development initiatives, and fully engaging newcomers so that they are in every way an integral part of our community. Global Cleveland is the only organization in our region doing this critical work. As board chair, I want to thank you for your collaboration and partnership, and particularly for your support of Global Cleveland. Now, I'm going to hand it back to Joe to give us an update on the state of Global Cleveland.
Thank you so much, David. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you and welcome our newest board members. I also want to acknowledge and say thank you to Joe Lopez and Mari Galindo, who are stepping off of our board right now and who have provided years of service to this organization. We are grateful to have worked with each and every one of you. The work that we do is work that happens every single day in terms of how we try to reach out to the people among us. We were formed in 2011 by the Cleveland Foundation, the Jewish Federation of Cleveland, the Tamar and Milton Maltz Foundation, and the Audrey and Albert Ratner Foundation, along with the Gunn Foundation and a host of private companies. Drawing inspiration from the Jewish community and Tikkun Olam, an idea that means what we try to do is repair the world and make the world work in a way for the people and the sisters and brothers among us. Our inspiration comes from the people that we work with every single day. Our goal has evolved from raising awareness of the value of welcoming newcomers to creating and being a part of the conversation, to becoming an indispensable resource in the international community, bolstering the local economy and prosperity, not just for the international newcomer, the immigrant, or the refugee, but the people who were born and raised here in Cleveland, our sisters and brothers in the African-American community, the native-born community here in Cleveland, people who have moved to Cleveland from other parts in one integrated community, in the theory and the idea and the lived reality of what Dr. Martin Luther King used to call the beloved community. Where we are now, we realize that immigration is economic development. We also realize that kindness is economic development. And we work every day to achieve these goals of success and compassion. And we look to things like the New American Economy, a national rating score that looks at 100 American cities in terms of how well we're doing of welcoming immigrants. Many years ago when this started, Cleveland was ranked 64th. This past year, we are ranked number 21. And if you know Global Cleveland and you know the people that we work for, we won't stop until we crack the top 10. But we also know that every single year, we have to take stock and simply say thank you for all of the institutions who are doing everything they can every single day to make people feel more welcome. I'm thinking about Cleveland State University and its increase in international students under the leadership of Dr. Sands. I'm thinking about Case Western Reserve University with our chairman, Vice Provost Fleshler, who works every day to build those bridges around the globe. And I'm thinking about our very own Cuyahoga Community College under the incredible, incredible leadership, Dr. Johnson, working to make sure that English as a learning language and the access to the workforce is something that's achieved on a daily basis. We feel very, very fortunate to host the Sister Cities Conference, a conference that right now not only welcomes our 24 sister cities, but in October of this coming year, will personally and physically welcome those people from around the world. Our Ambassador and Diplomat Series, where we've hosted 7 ambassadors connecting to our diaspora communities here in Cleveland, in terms of making sure that that bridge is crossed over and over again in both directions by people here and from around the world. And our Global Employer Summit, which helps over 50 companies solve the workforce dilemma of how to make sure that companies have the people they need to do the jobs they do while growing our community for the future that we all want to succeed at. Our civic engagement has grown. Several years ago, we were naturalizing about 2,600 new US citizens a year. Right before COVID, we were on track to doubling that number of 5,000. And as we look forward to getting back in person and making sure that naturalizations continue to increase, there's no reason why we couldn't be near 7 or 8,000 naturalizations annually here in Northeast Ohio, seeing those individuals from around the world calling Cleveland home. Our welcoming week every September is the envy of cities across the country. 25 different events bringing our community together, those born here, those born abroad, and telling the story of Cleveland through the magnifying glass and the microscope of the international community here in Northeast Ohio. And of course, this year, our candidates forums, the first time we've ever tried this, including over 22 nonprofits in Cleveland who have part of their mission being an international focus, hosting the council races and the mayor's races in the city of Cleveland with over 75 people running for office, engaging with our international community, learning what we do, and learning how they too could be an ally for the people that we work with. An ally like people like Matt Carroll. Matt Carroll, who is now on our board, who works under the leadership of County Executive Armin Budish. And we are thrilled to report that the county is in the process of working to become a welcoming certified county, a county that looks at all of its systems and all of its departments and says, what more can we do to be welcoming to people who come to see our county and work and live here who come from another country? Under the leadership of County Executive Budish, with Chief Matt Carroll and Council President Pernell Jones, along with Economic Director Paul Herdig, Councilwoman Yvonne Conwell, and Councilman Marty Sweeney, we are ready to become the second certified welcoming county in the state of Ohio and become the best at what we do, which is making sure that people feel at home here. We were thrilled this past year to host International Women's Month in March and ready to double our efforts for this coming March. And the direct assistance that we provide to immigrant communities, the direct day-to-day support in terms of language access, vaccine access, our program called InterCLE, which works with our international students from our colleges and universities around Ohio, our professional connections where people come to us, we give help with resumes, we provide references for jobs, and we work to make sure that people can live their best lives here. And of course, we couldn't do a year review without looking at the crisis of our sisters and brothers in Afghanistan. Working collaboratively with the organizations that resettle refugees here in Cleveland, we were thrilled to partner in very short time and work to provide visas for people who had assisted the United States in Afghanistan to come and move to Cleveland to make this home. This wasn't easy, but good work rarely is. And when the call went out to you, to our foundations, to our leaders, you responded. Thousands of dollars were raised, hundreds of legal hours were offered, clothes and food was donated, and Global Cleveland was thrilled to be a part of the effort to welcome our newest sisters and brothers from Afghanistan. We continue to work diligently to make us a more welcoming community. From our Global Entrepreneur in Residence program, where we can be a force to make sure that our talent doesn't leave Northeast Ohio after it's educated here, after people gain important skills, but they stay here, they open their companies, and they share their best gifts. It's an ongoing question with housing and employment access for all of our immigrants, including our refugees and sisters and brothers from Afghanistan and around the world. If you are an employer or you have a place that you think somebody could call home, an apartment or a house, please let us know. Working collaboratively with the six organizations that provide these services to refugees, we want to make sure that our newcomers have the best that Northeast Ohio has to offer. We are so excited about a strategic plan that we're launching the first week of January for our next 10 years. And I'm thrilled to announce that we will be launching a podcast in the next few days, where we've already interviewed a half a dozen people in terms of their journeys here. People that you may have heard of, people like Beju Shaw, our first founder here at Global Cleveland, our first board chair, and somebody who leads the Greater Cleveland Partnership, sharing his own story. People like our own colleague, a public service fellow from the Cleveland Foundation, Fatima Rahman, who talks about what it's like for her to live her lived experience as someone that's part of the DACA program, as someone who understands how important it is for all of us to understand the incredible gifts and talents and skills that our newcomers provide. And people like Lean Anjaluni, who's currently living in Amman, Jordan, who was in Cleveland and wants to return, and talking about the struggle that she faces. These are real stories. These are real people. This is real work. And there's real hardship and also real joy. And we're thrilled to share all of this. What's the point? It's pretty straightforward. That Cleveland, Cuyahoga County, and Northeast Ohio become the most welcoming place in North America. We know that you are here to help us reach that goal. We are determined to reach that goal. We will reach that goal. And I hope that you are all as excited as I am about the next 10 years of Global Cleveland. We could not do this work without you. We are a small but mighty staff who responds to an overwhelming and mighty army. And that army is something that we are very proud of. We'd like to award some of those people who've helped us do this important work. My friends, it is now time to honor our wonderful and incredible awardees.
Hello, my name is Teresa Metcalf-Beasley, and I am the chair of the McDonnell Hopkins Public Law Group. It is my pleasure to be with you today to present Global Cleveland's 2021 Youth Leader Award. This year's award is given to a friend and supporter of Global Cleveland, Malak Rashid. Malak is the Development Director for Smart Development, a nonprofit that provides housing, community improvement, social services, and civic engagement services to the refugee, immigrant, and limited English speaking communities. She began volunteering for Global Cleveland in 2019, helping to translate information about the U.S. Census, and advocating to get out the count in the Arab-speaking community in Northeast Ohio. She continued to work with Global Cleveland in 2020 and 2021, helping to translate vital public health information regarding COVID-19 while working full-time and navigating the pandemic herself. Malak exemplifies excellence in leadership and inspires other young members of the community to lead and help build global bridges. Please join me in congratulating Malak on her incredible leadership.
Thank you, Teresa. I am really appreciative and beyond thankful to be awarded the Youth Leader Award by Global Cleveland. I've been working with Global Cleveland for almost 3 years now. I initially started working with Joe through advocacy for the refugee and immigrant community in regards to employment opportunities, and most notably throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. From 2020 to present, I've worked closely with the staff of Global Cleveland to engage the Arabic speaking community with the census, as well as some voting, and as of course with the daily translations that Global Cleveland spearheaded to make sure that English learning communities had access to relevant and necessary COVID-19 information. You know, I do my best to really try and be an advocate for my community and those who could use my skill set and learn from me along the way as I learn from them. And I'm really thankful to Global Cleveland for always affording me the opportunity to be a part of a greater cause and furthering the intersectional points of our great community across Greater Cleveland, and making sure that all communities and all people, regardless of them being English learners or just Arabic speakers or speaker of any language from any community in any country, feel included and heard through the work of Global Cleveland. And I'm just very thankful to have received this award. And I hope to continue to be able to work with the Global Cleveland staff and really continue to further their mission and make sure that, you know, immigrants and refugees continue to thrive across Cleveland. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Emily Garpacetti, and I am the Vice President and Community Affairs Officer at the Federal Reserve Bank of Cleveland. I am consistently amazed at the diversity of people that Global Cleveland brings together in common struggle, in community, and in celebration. And this is just another example of that. Today, it is my pleasure to present the Volunteer of the Year Award to Sergio Robles. Sergio is an assistant professor of instruction in marketing at Ohio University, as well as a member of the Federal Reserve Bank of Cleveland's Equity and Inclusion Advisory Council. Thank you, Sergio, for serving on that important council. He has volunteered with Global Cleveland for the past 2 years, providing mentorship not to one or two, but three members of the inaugural Global Rising cohort. He's passionate about connecting with Cleveland's immigrant community and is always ready to lend a helping hand. Sergio exemplifies excellence in volunteering and helps us build global bridges. Congratulations, Sergio, and thank you for being an advocate of Global Cleveland and the international community.
All right, well, thank you everybody for this nomination of Volunteer of the Year Award. For me, as a native Clevelander, this is a very big honor. One of the reasons I decided to volunteer with Global Cleveland last year is because, over the years I've gotten scholarships from the Cleveland community, especially through Esperanza. And, one of the conditions of the scholarship was that we were gonna repay the Cleveland community. So I can't think of a better way to do so through volunteering with Global Cleveland, especially with the Hispanic community and with the immigrants and the refugees that are coming. And I hope to do this next time and next year and for years to come. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Phil Thomas, CEO and Executive Director of the Cleveland Public Library. And I'm proud to announce Tristan Wheeler as the Volunteer of the Year Award for Global Cleveland. I think why Tristan received this award was not only because he has been a solid contributor to the Sister Cities Conference and working behind the scenes to really help make that successful, but also some may not know that when the Afghan refugees were coming to Cleveland in August, Tristan volunteered to go and be our kind of representative from the library to do technology work behind the scenes to make that as successful as it could be. Tristan is just one of those people who we are just very proud to have as a member of our Cleveland Public Library team. And we congratulate him on being Volunteer of the Year for Global Cleveland.
With sincere gratitude, I'd like to thank Global Cleveland and their incredible team for all that they do for our beautiful city of Cleveland. May your efforts reach far into future generations' lives and impact the culture of this city in the best of ways. I am grateful that I've been inspired and able to do all that I can for our brothers and sisters, and hope that I can continue to work towards the improvement of our city. Thank you for this Volunteer of the Year award, and let's continue to connect the people of Cleveland to the rest of the globe.
Good morning. My name is Sia New Yorker, and I'm an anchor reporter with WOIO-TV, also known as 19 News, here in Cleveland, Ohio. And I am thrilled to present the Global Cleveland's Media Partner Award this morning. Now, this award is given to a person here in our community who exemplifies storytelling and in regards to our newcomer community here in Northeast Ohio. Now this year, it is my pleasure to present that award to Cameron Fields, who is a talented young reporter with Cleveland.com. Now you may know Cameron, we all know Cameron. Cameron's always tweeting and engaging us on social media and Twitter. He covers a plethora of topics from the pandemic to business development to social justice issues, and he's always willing to report on the international and the immigrant community here in Cleveland. Now, he first came to Global Cleveland from reporting on Global and Welcoming Week. That was back in 2020. Since then, he's embraced every opportunity to talk about the community, learn about the international community, and tell their stories, really give a human face to some of those newcomers here in our area. Now, Cameron understands the importance of representing the international community here to our broader community. By reporting on some of these issues, Cameron and Cleveland.com let the community know that it is important to hear these stories, embrace these stories, and welcome our newcomers here to Northeast Ohio. And he did that really, really well during August 2021, back over the summer. So we want to tell Cameron, thank you for all the work and everything that you do, and present you with this award. And we want to let people know that these stories are impactful. These stories have meaning. So we want to thank you very much, Cameron, and encourage you to keep doing this important work, because it is much needed and much appreciated here in Northeast Ohio. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. First, I would like to thank you all for having me here. I am honored to accept Global Cleveland's Media Partner Award. Thank you so much for recognizing me with this honor. I started full-time at Cleveland.com in August of last year, and one of my early assignments was to report about Welcoming Week. I got to meet Joe Semperman while on this assignment, and since then, it's been a joy to report about Cleveland's newcomer communities. The international communities in Cleveland are strong and vibrant, and talking with residents is always a pleasure. Writing about Cleveland's international communities is important work. When the Taliban regained control of Afghanistan in August, I was tasked with following the rapidly developing situation. I knew the stories needed to be as informative as possible, especially if anyone wanted to offer help. I appreciate that I got to help inform readers about the situation in Afghanistan
And the stories about the refugees coming to Cleveland and other parts of the country still need to be told as they embark on their journeys. I want to thank God for blessing me with not only my writing skills, but the ability to empathize and listen to people. To me, hearing people out and listening to their perspectives are the most important aspects of reporting. I also want to thank my family and friends for supporting me throughout my endeavors. I wouldn't be here without their love. Thank you again for this award, and I appreciate you having me here today.
Hi, my name is Dorit, and I'm the director of the partnership between Cleveland, Beit She'an, and the Valley of Springs in Israel. For 115 years, the Jewish Federation of Cleveland has worked to ensure that the Cleveland community is welcoming and inclusive of all people. It has promoted the overall well-being of Cleveland by encouraging everyone to fulfill the responsibility of Tikkun Olam, to make the world a better place. As a founding member of Global Cleveland, the Federation has inspired this organization and many others to follow their lead and build collaborative relationships that drive meaningful social change. The Federation is focused on impact, and as someone who feels the impact in my own communities, words cannot express how meaningful their support is for us. It is because its dedication to building bridges and inclusive communities in ways that no one person or organization could do alone that I am honored to present the Global Community Builder Award to the Jewish Federation of Cleveland. I am honored to invite David Heller, Board Chair of the Federation, to accept the award on behalf of the Jewish Federation of Cleveland. Congratulations.
Dorit, thank you. It's great to see you again. And it seems like just yesterday we were together, even though it was this past July in Beit She'an. What a wonderful experience to be with you and all the wonderful people in Beit She'an and the Valley of Springs. As the board chair of the Jewish Federation of Cleveland, I'm honored tonight to accept this esteemed award. We have been working with Global Cleveland for over 10 years, and the work that we do in the community has been such an incredible partnership of collaboration. The work that we do together, our two organizations, really shows what we can do and how we can be stronger when we work together. The work that you do in the community with the immigrant populations, as well as overseas on the work with partnership cities, including Beit She'an, is something that is near and dear to our heart. We look forward to a lifelong partnership with Global Cleveland. We're honored to be an honoree tonight, and I just want to congratulate the other honorees on their incredible work in the community. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is John Corlett, and I'm the president and executive director for the Center for Community Solutions. It is my absolute pleasure to be with you here this morning to award the Albert B. and Audrey G. Ratner Community Leader Award to a very deserving individual, Dr. Akram Boutros. Dr. Boutros is the visionary president and CEO of the Metro Health System. And under his leadership, Metro Health has grown to more than 20 community health centers, 4 hospitals, 5 Metro Express Care locations, and 10 pharmacies. When the COVID-19 pandemic hit, Dr. Boutros led the charge to ensure that everyone would have access to tests and vaccinations and healthcare. His collaborative spirit and focus on inclusion, diversity, and equity has led to the betterment of our community. And as an immigrant himself, Dr. Boutros understands the importance and value in welcoming international newcomers and all they have to offer to our communities. There is no doubt that he has made an exceptional impact on Cleveland. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so honored to present this year's Global Cleveland Albert B. and Audrey G. Ratner Community Leader Award to my good friend, Dr. Akram Boutros. Congratulations, Dr. Boutros.
To the staff and board of Global Cleveland, to Joe Semperman, to Albert and Audrey Ratner, the entire Ratner family, and all of you here today, thank you. I want to also recognize Andrea Pierce-Lee and Bert Saltzman, the previous recipients of the Community Leader Award. It is an honor to be associated with you and with the endless good that Albert and Audrey Ratner do for the community. They support the arts, education, healthcare. They help organizations for overcoming poverty and many more causes. They are a model for every engaged and caring Clevelander. One reason I was selected to receive this award, I'm told, was because of MetroHealth's response to the COVID crisis, the way in which we stepped up to help test and vaccinate all people, whether they were Black or Brown or white, whether they had insurance or not, whether they lived in a comfortable home or had no home at all. As such, this award belongs to all the MetroHealth employees who worked so hard during the most trying of times to make that happen, who lived up to the motto history assigned to us years ago as an institution committed to a lifetime of work in the relief of human suffering. They also live by our motto today of hope, health, and healing. It is their dedicated spirit and commitment that I am grateful for. I also want to congratulate Global Cleveland on its 10th anniversary. What an amazing milestone. And for its work to ensure that more than 4,500 immigrants and refugees in Cleveland received COVID care they deserve and other care they deserve. Care that strengthens our city and welcomes newcomers as neighbors and friends. It is one more way you continue the beautiful tradition of Tikkun Olam, repairing the world, working toward the social justice that is at the heart of all we do at MetroHealth. To every one of you who work for or support Global Cleveland. Thank you.
Today, I have the great honor to present a new award from Global Cleveland. This first-time award is named after Mansfield Fraser, remarkable leader and community activist. The award will be given each year and will be known as the Mansfield Fraser City Builder Award. For those of you who did not know him, let me give you a brief understanding of Mansfield Fraser. Mr. Fraser was a pillar of the Cleveland community, widely admired by all who knew him. He was the owner of Chateau Huff, an urban winery that provided work for people who were formerly incarcerated, giving these men and women opportunities that others refused to give them. Through their work at Chateau Huff, Mr. Fraser's employees demonstrated their commitment and ability, allowing them to become full and valuable members of our community. Mr. Fraser also founded Neighborhood Solutions, a nonprofit focused on using educational and entrepreneurial strategies to help formerly incarcerated people re-enter society. Mr. Fraser died earlier this year, and we mourn his passing with his family and with the entire community. Mr. Fraser was an exceptional mentor and fearless leader. He was dogged in his determination to build Cleveland into a better place for everyone. Global Cleveland shares the beliefs and values exemplified by Mansfield Fraser, which is why we created the Mansfield Fraser City Builder Award. It gives me enormous pleasure to present the inaugural Mansfield Fraser City Builder Award to Richie Paperinen, Director of Urban Theory and Analytics at Cleveland State University and one of the founders of Rust Belt Analytica. Richie embodies the same qualities as Mr. Fraser, including perhaps especially his determination and desire to help build a better Cleveland. As the co-founder of Rust Belt Analytica, Richie utilizes data and innovative analysis to uncover trends that support economic growth and individual well-being, which ultimately improves our city for its residents. His most recent study, Migration is Economic Development, demonstrates with impressive data and analysis how and why migrant and immigrant attraction and integration is a sure predictor of economic success for a region. I am proud to say that Global Cleveland commissioned this important study and is using it in partnership with companies and institutions throughout the region. Ritchie's study demonstrates that if all of us are working to attract, retain, and integrate migrants, immigrants, and refugees, we not only will see more successful and profitable organizations, we will have a more economically vibrant region. Ritchie, on a personal note, I want to say how extraordinarily honored I am to be able to present this award to you, and by extension, to your beautiful family. You and I have worked closely together for many years. You are one of the most courageous and inspirational people I know. Your work at Cleveland State and Rust Belt Analytica is not really work, it is passion. I know of no one who cares more for this city or this region. I know of no one who is more dedicated to not only improving the lives of all our citizens, but to assuring that those who have the least benefit the most from our region's jobs and economic advancement. You have made and you continue to make a profound effect on Cleveland's institutions, including our governments, corporations, nonprofits, foundations, and universities. Mostly, however, your work is making a difference in the lives of everyday people in Greater Cleveland. Ritchie, your work helps our community to recognize and understand the importance of what Global Cleveland does every day. Together, we are building a better and a greater Cleveland. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating Ritchie Papereinen, the recipient of Global Cleveland's first ever Mansfield Fraser City Builder Award.
So thank you, Global Cleveland, for this award, the Mansfield Fraser Award. I got to know Mansfield pretty well. He's a great writer, a great visionary. He told it, you know, told it like it is, didn't pull punches. And that's kind of, you know, that's something that I think I espouse in my work. I love Cleveland, but Cleveland can be a tough place to love. It can be resistant to change. A lot of what I tried to do is push the city forward, push it forward with forward thinking, and which ties in directly to Global Cleveland's work, the migration of knowledge, the migration of ideas to evolve Cleveland into a better place. So again, thank you, Global Cleveland. I'm really honored. Thank you very much.
To Teresa, to Malak, to Emily, to Sergio, to Felton, Tristan, Sia, and Cameron, to Dorit and David, to John and Dr. Boutrous, David and Ritchie, thank you, congratulations, and thank you for everything you do. And to everyone who was texting me across the world, apagaste tu camera, isclopil si fotoaparat, and tu vuclochiu camera, that my camera was off. To my Spanish, Slovenian, and Russian friends, I thank you. I also appreciate that getting texts in different languages is something wonderful at this job. And I want to thank each and every one of you for everything that you do. Now, the moment that we've all been waiting for. It is time to pull the winning raffle ticket for a trip for two to beautiful Italy. For this raffle, we partnered with Italian Tours by Diana, a boutique travel agency here in Northeast Ohio in Rocky River. Diana focuses on crafting custom journeys to Italy and Europe. And today, one very lucky person is going to win an 8-day Italian journey through our sister city, Vicenza, as well as Venice, Florence, Rome, and the beautiful destinations in between. We have been promoting this raffle for some time. I have the tickets here. We are filming this so that everyone can see this if you want to at some point. And I will now draw the winning ticket. Imaginary drum roll, please. And the winner is Jim Cavoli. Mr. Jim Cavoli. Jim, congratulations. If you're on, congratulations. We will be informing you very soon in person that you won this wonderful trip. Congratulations to you, Jim. We're very grateful for your support. Thank you very much to everybody who participated in our wonderful raffle here. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining us today. I want to thank our presenting sponsor, Medical Mutual, Dave's Supermarket, Swage Lock, Tom and Joni Adler, Welcome House, Refugee Response, Team Neo, Cleveland State University, NRP, the Cleveland Public Library, Playhouse Square, Brown Immigration Services, Margaret Wong and Associates, and Sustainable Cleveland, Josh, Ben, and Naomi. I want to thank each of you for participating. I want to thank all of our international newcomers. We could not be here for 10 years if it weren't for our collaborators, supporters, and upstanders, and most of all, our incredible immigrant community that we love and embrace every single day. We couldn't do this work without our amazing volunteers and our board and our supportive, innumerable partners. At Global Cleveland, we believe in taking care of our own. The international community is our own. You are our own. And we will continue to love and embrace you for decades to come. To those where it's morning, good morning. To those where it's afternoon, good afternoon. And to those around the world where night has fallen, good evening. We cannot wait to celebrate 2022 with you. Thank you all very, very much. Have a wonderful rest of your day. DJ Shake, please play us out.
All right, Joe, thank you very much. We truly appreciate you. And everybody out there at Global Cleveland, thank you all for tuning in and joining us for your annual meeting 2021. We want to give a great and huge shout out to our sponsors and, of course, Medical Mutual, who presented this lovely meeting. I go by the name of DJ Shake. I'm going to go ahead and close out this meeting with some great vibes. You all enjoy the rest of your day. Stick around. Peace.
I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay.
Way back way, you know that I don't play. Streets not safe, but I never run away. Even when I'm away, OT, OT, there's never much love when we go OT. I pray to make it back in one piece. I pray That's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand.
One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. Strength and guidance, all that I'm wishing for my friends. Nobody makes it from my ends. I had to bust up the silence. You know you gotta stick by me. Soon as you see the text, reply me. I don't wanna spend time fighting. We got no time and that's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me.
Y empezamos como es. Mi música no discrimina a nadie, así que vamos a romper. Toda mi gente se mueve. Mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene. El mundo nos quiere, me quiere a mí. Toda mi gente se mueve. Mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene. Mi música los tiene fuerte bailando y se baila así. La fiesta no para, apenas comienza. C'est comme si, c'est comme ça. Ma chérie, la 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 la. Francia, Colombia, me gusta. Freeze. J Balvin, Willy William, me gusta. Freeze. Los DJ no mienten, le gusta a mi gente y eso se fue muy bien. No le bajamos, mas nunca paramos. Es otro palo y blanco.
¿Y dónde está mi gente? Me fue a coger la tete. ¿Y dónde está mi gente?
Que tú eres mía, mía, tú sabes que eres mía, mía. Tú misma lo decías cuando yo te lo hacía.
Como de la, contigo me sube, lo verás. Te toco y hasta el mundo de hoy.
tirarte. Que a ti nadie va a tocar. Dile que tú eres mía, mía. Tú sabes que eres mía, mía. Tú misma lo decías. Cuando yo te lo hacía, hacía. Te dit les thunes, qui dit argent dit dépense, qui dit crédit dit créance, qui dit dette te dit huissier, lui dit assis dans la merde, qui dit amour dit les gosses, dit toujours et dit divorce, qui dit proche te dit deuil car les problèmes ne viennent pas seuls, qui dit crise te dit monde, et dit famine dit tiers monde, et qui dit fatigue dit réveil, encore sourd de la veille, alors on sort pour oublier tous les problèmes, alors on danse. 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 Et là tu dis que c'est fini, car pire que ça, ce serait la mort. Quand tu crois enfin que tu t'en sors, quand y en a plus, eh ben y en a encore. Et cela zique tous les problèmes, tous les problèmes ou bien la musique. Ça te prend les tripes, ça te prend la tête, et puis tu pries pour que ça s'arrête. Mais c'est ton corps, c'est pas le ciel, alors tu ne bouges plus les oreilles. Et là tu cries encore plus fort, mais ça persiste, alors on chante. La, 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 la.
Making all the dummy tonight. Joanna, your busy body giving me life, oh. Hey, life, hey.
How you do me like that?
Joanna, Joanna.
How you do me like that?
Hey, Joanna, Joanna.
How you gonna do me like that?
Joanna, Joanna.
Hey, Joanna.
Hey, Joanna, Joanna.
How you gonna play me like Drogba, ho, Drogba, ho? How you gonna do me like Drogba, ho, Drogba, ho? Oh, DJ Drogba, ho, Drogba, ho? Eh, DJ Drogba, ho,
se me deportó.